Welcome to the AHA Show. The challenge that I went through after, you know, the third time I was diagnosed with cancer, which was a much more serious one, you know. Look, I've had my womanhood taken away. I've had, you know, the breast, I've had the, you know, everything, full hysterectomy, you know, the whole nine yards, but she didn't take it away from me. But what I did find out in that time, the people that I thought were the closest to me, that I supported so much in business, they didn't do the same in return to me when I needed them the most. And when I became vulnerable, that's when a lot of times people did take more advantage of me, and that hurt more than words can ever describe. And I think that I went into a place where I had to move, and I had to go to Bali, and I had to go to really look within. And I had to go into that quiet space. And I had two roads I could choose, couldn't I? I could have either gotten in the fetal position, and that could have been the end of me, because mind over matter, the sickness could have taken me because I would have been so depressed. Or I could have said, nope, you're not gonna beat me. I know who I am, and I know my heart, and I know how I love, and I know how I've supported everybody, and the world is not all bad, and it isn't. And because I was so stuck in the Beverly Hills mentality that success only means money, and that's all that it means to these people, and they will walk over you because they're out for them and what they can do for them. But not everybody is like that. And so when I had to go and I had to leave the country and I had to just go and get into that space and into reading Eckhart Tolle, The Power of Now changed my life. The Untethered Soul changed my life. Got rid of the cell phone, got rid of everything. And it wasn't an easy time. And I didn't know how to turn it off. I didn't know how to embrace the silence. And I didn't understand what ego meant. It wasn't what I thought it meant in Beverly Hills. When I really understood what ego really meant and I really got myself out of it, that's what allowed me to just be and be the best that I can be. And when that happened and I experienced that, I was able to come back. And when the diagnosis kept getting worse and worse and worse, and I had to go through all those surgeries, and I did it alone. And I would pass out leaving the doctor's office, and the doctor would look at me and say, who's with you? Who's taking you? You just got the double mastectomy. Couldn't even lift my arms. I said, I took an Uber. And on the last time, I passed out in the hallway. And then, you know, they had to call, you know, caretakers to come and take care of me. So I went through all that, and I didn't let it kill me. And I let it made me grow stronger. And then it opened up doors that I did not know could be opened. And that is where my true friends came out. And that is where I feel, I'm very spiritual. I feel that God and my spirit guides allowed wonderful people to come in my life. And that's where God sent to me Chris Pollinger, my business partner. He sent to me Bernice Ross. He sent to me some wonderful, amazing people that have had my back, that have stood by my side, and no matter what, they did it with love, and they did it with support, and they didn't expect anything in return, and they didn't want anything from me. And I didn't know that that was possible in this world. And it was all from love, and it opened up a door, and it opened up other beautiful people to come in my life and to come into my space. And I feel like with the AHA moment, I wanna share how that can happen for you. And I wanna share what that's looked like for me. And one of the best things that anybody ever told me was my gorgeous, beautiful, lovely little friend, Madison Hildebrand, which was on Million Dollar Listing. And I'll never forget, he sat with me one night. I was at his house, and I had maybe at this time, maybe five people in my life had known really the full story of what had happened. And it was after the cancer, you know, things happened before my cancer. Well, he knew all of it. And so everybody flocked around after the cancer because they thought I was gonna die, so everybody wanted to be there. But what about before? Where were you? Everybody dropped me. Well, Madison sat down with me, and it was at his house very late at night, and he looked at me and he said, I'm mad at you. you have done something to me. And I had no idea what he meant. And I said, what do you mean? He said, you took something away from me. And I said, what? And he said, you know, you went through all of this. He said, do you have any idea how bad you have hurt me, where you took the ability away from me to be there for you and be a support system for you and to just be a friend to you? He goes, do you, and he started to cry. He goes, do you know what that would have done to me had you died? And I didn't have that opportunity. And I would have had to look at you down in the casket and know that you didn't even tell me. And you called me your friend and you took that away from me. He goes, don't you ever do that to me again. No matter what you go through, you need to know I love you and I support you. No matter what it is, I'm here for you. Don't take that away from me. So I ask you right now, what are you going through and who are you not telling and who are you not allowing to be there for you? I hope that message is well received.